Romans rebelled, and a third of them were cast from heaven, that they were cast from heaven to make war against the saints. So we are the focus of spiritual activity. Angels ministering for us, demons warring against us, and one of their attacks, one of their principal attacks, is condemnation. So when you sense condemnation, inferiority, insecurity, and all the things that go with that, telling you that you're unworthy, you must rebuke that lie and stand on the truth of God's word. The enemy also has, we say the word enemy, and that's kind of, in my opinion, not being specific. It's demons that we deal with. But one of their works is to intimidate you with so-called demonstrations of their power, maybe through false dreams, false feelings, different aspects of false demonstrations. Don't be intimidated by these type of things, but always measure your spiritual experiences with the Word of God. That's not hard to do, and that's another way to stay free. You may find yourself tempted, most likely you will, in the area of old habits. And I would say if I was a demon, one of the things I would be asking is what worked before? How did we get access to this life before? What did they fall for in the past? What are they prone to? And so the desires and old habits, the old nature, you must recognize and guard against that. And many times the work of a demon is to make you feel different and unaccepted, that you're strange and you don't fit in, and those kind of lies. You must always be able to recognize and resist those lies, because you are accepted. And the only strange thing about a believer is that we are peculiar, we are different. But demons can intimidate you sometimes through those lies. And some positive principles, scriptural principles. Focus your attention on Jesus. And let me say that another way. Don't think too much about demons. Don't give them too much credit. Don't attribute everything that goes wrong to demons. Might be, might not be. But focus your attention on Jesus. Don't think about demons when you go to sleep. Don't wonder if they're going to torment you in a dream. Don't wonder if they're in the room or they're in your house. Or don't give them any credit. Focus on Jesus and focus on truth. And allow the Holy Spirit to have His complete way with you. Doesn't matter. Just allow the Holy Spirit to bless you and direct you. And when you turn your focus from demons to Jesus and to receiving from the Holy Spirit, I guarantee you, you will see a difference. And a third positive principle is to immerse yourself with Scripture. Know the truth. Know what God says and agree with it. Whatever God's Word says, agree with it. Come into agreement with what the written Word of God says. And then when you're dealing with demon powers, don't be tentative. Know that you have authority in the name of Jesus, that the work's already done. Command demons to obey in the name of Jesus. Don't just request it, command it, but command it with His authority, the authority of the name of Jesus. Sometimes I say this even in my warfare, and I have to say I don't even like the word warfare, because we always win. But in my warfare, many times I'll say, maybe you don't know who I am, demon. Maybe you don't know how this works. But I'm a child of God. I'm washed in the blood. I'm an heir of God and a joint heir with Jesus Christ, and you're messing with me. With that kind of boldness, not cockiness, not self-confidence, but confidence in the truth of God's Word. He has given me authority in His name to stand against the wiles of the devil. So learn to command them with authority in the name of Jesus. And this is not necessarily the final thing I'm going to say, but it's a very important thing, is you must separate yourself from your old friends. The friends that you like to hang around when the demons had their way in your life. You must fellowship with believers, and not just with believers, but with strong believers. Choose people who lift you up, and by being in their presence, that you're not going to be tempted to do something that's going to open a door. You're not going to listen to a conversation that's going to take your mind to the wrong places. But surround yourself with strong, encouraging believers. And do things that please Jesus. That I would say is probably the simplest way to keep demons out of your life. Just do things that please Jesus. And not only will you please Him in doing that, but you'll be able to stay free. And so it sometimes in deliverance, when people go through a deliverance session, their life has changed in this respect. They've lost some old friends. They've lost a part of their life that used to give them comfort in a strange way, used to be a part of their flesh and their personality. Now it's gone. And I hear people say to me sometimes, I feel like, 20 pounds have been lifted off of me, or I feel like I've been washed with a stream going through me, like taking a shower from the inside out. My mind is clear. It's not dark anymore. Those kind of things are real common in deliverance. But at the same time, a part of you is gone. A part of the old way of thinking is gone. So those things you replace with new ways of thinking, with God's way of thinking. And so pleasing Him is real important. And I want to say something that you may never have heard. It's not a new doctrine. It's not a strange doctrine. It's something that I discovered when I was writing the books on deliverance. The verses that you're familiar with, that you've heard and maybe even feared most of your life, where Jesus said, when the unclean spirit is gone out of a man, he walks in dry places seeking rest and can't find any. And so he visits with his friends in the dry places, the other demons, and he says, I know what I'll do. I'll go back to my old house and I'll take 7 more evil than myself with me. And so the demons made decisions. They made a strategic move. They said, we'll go back. And that puzzled me as I was writing the book. I was even asking God, maybe for a month in prayer, what's the point in casting out demons if they can come back and come back with greater strength? Why am I even doing this? What am I missing in the scripture? That doesn't even sound like you, God, for a person to be 7 times worse after he's free. I said, I don't get it. And so I prayed about that for at least a month. And virtually every time I would read that scripture, it was like the Holy Spirit would say to me, read it again. And I don't know how many times I may have read it, but one day it clicked. The scripture doesn't say when the unclean spirit is cast out of a man. It says when he's gone out. And the implication is that he goes out on his own accord. He goes out and says, well, I think I'll go check some other places, see if I can get a better home, see if I can get a better deal. Maybe he goes out because he's uncomfortable. Maybe the person's listening to praise music, and that's a great way to stay free is to immerse yourself with praise and praise to be a part of your life. I don't know why the demons left in this scripture that Jesus shared, but they weren't cast out. They went out on their own. And since they went out on their own, there was still a doorway. There was still a door that hadn't been closed, and they said, well, I'll go back to my house. I still got a house. I still got a door. They weren't cast out. But when the demon is cast out, the door is closed, and demons can't come back. So don't fear that verse of scripture that says, well, if I go through deliverance, I might get seven more. That's not what it says, and that's not what the implication is. There's plenty out there, so if there's an open door, you can get a demon. But don't fear that there's going to be droves of demons come, because that's not what that scripture implies. It implies that they've gone out, they still got a door, so they can come back. But when demons are cast out and the doors are closed, it's a done deal. And so you can walk in freedom, you can stay free, and you can keep doors closed. And I just want to encourage you, don't take anything off demons. I don't know who it was, but somebody said in your dictionary you should cut out two words. You should cut out quit and can't. Just cut those out of your dictionary. I would say in your spiritual vocabulary, just cut out the words that defeat, that you can walk in victory. That's something that God's Word has promised. That's something that Jesus paid for. And so I encourage you to stand strong, to stand on Scripture, and to not be intimidated by demon powers. And if this DVD is a blessing to you, you can copy it, reprint it, distribute it, whatever you want to do with it. Our purpose for this is to let you know, walking in freedom when pigs move out is not really that hard, and I encourage you to do it in the name of Jesus.
Before I leave today, there's some things I wanted to include in this little video, but actually it's too lengthy, and we'll be producing another video about this, but this is very important to staying free. I encourage you, do not engage in territorial warfare against principalities, regional demons. Keep your focus on yourself, and as warfare pertains to you, bind those demons, cast those demons out. But it's pointless and it's dangerous to engage in territorial warfare of demons related to communities, to individuals. That's an absolute danger area. And we'll have another video coming soon about that. And I guess a good title for that would be Don't Go There. It's pointless and it's dangerous. Keep your focus on yourself and your family and things that God has given you authority over. And that would not include communities and nations and countries and demons that have legal rights in those areas. So as an added word to this How to Stay Free segment, don't go there in relation to territorial warfare. And I pray you just have a blessed journey in staying free.